This right here might be EcoFlow's coolest yet dumbest product they have ever made. This little Mars rover looking contraption is a solar tracker that basically allows your solar panel to follow the sun all day long in an effort to produce maximum energy. They are really cool in theory, and our neighbors get a kick out of watching this thing spin around in our backyard. And they do make a lot of sense on a much larger scale with a much larger size array. But at $3,400 and the ability to only hold a maximum of 400 watts of panels, is it worth the investment? So welcome back to the lab. You guys know here, our opinions cannot be bought. Today we're looking at the EcoFlow solar tracker. However, this video kind of applies to any solar tracker in and around the same size and price range. They do have pros, don't get me wrong, but for the price of these things, the cons are pretty hard to argue. But before we jump into the results of our full sun up to sundown testing that we ran this thing through, we're gonna give you a super quick overview in case you're not already familiar with solar trackers. This solar tracker is basically fully self-contained and completely automatic. Any solar panel that you put on top of it is basically wired into the unit, and then the unit is wired into a power station or whatever you're trying to charge. It actually steals power from the panel, charges its own battery, and uses that energy to then follow the sun throughout the day. It doesn't actually need to be plugged into anything at all. It has a full almost 360 degree rotation, and the panel can go all the way up to 90 degrees and all the way back down to zero. And then it uses the sensor behind this little chrome window right here to basically just find the sun in the sky or the closest reflection that looks like the sun, and then follow its movement throughout the day and keep the solar panel at a 90 degree angle to the sun. And the whole idea with this thing is that it can get the most amount of solar input early in the morning and late at night, where when you have like a static array, the sun comes up and it's kind of hitting those panels on an angle. This thing will spin right to the sun, get the panel at the right angle, and be able to capture the maximum amount of energy available at that time. This one also has an app, so you can manually adjust its angle, although it's kind of stupid because as soon as you close the app, it just goes right back to defaulting automatic. So the pros with something like this as to why you might want one is it maximizes the energy early in the morning and late at night. So normal static arrays are getting their peak sun during the middle of the day. If you need solar power first thing in the morning, or you need it late into the evening, this guy will be able to help you produce the maximum amount at those times. Some of the cons of something especially like this of this size is that it is super expensive. A normal tracker can double the project cost. A tracker like this, I mean, it's a $187 solar panel mounted on a $3,400 tracker. That like 1,000x the cost of...
Not a math guy, but I don't think that makes very much sense.
No. And this one specifically, whoever put the code into this guy and taught it to follow the sun, forgot to put something in there where if it's tracking the sun and a cloud goes by, maybe wait 10 minutes to see if the cloud moves. Instead, as soon as this thing loses sight of the sun, it frantically spins in 360s, scanning the whole sky. If it can't find the sun, it then lays down in a completely inefficient position. It's not smart at all. And the last con is that this one specifically, this is the maximum size solar panel that it can hold. I actually scratched the living shit out of it just trying to get it on there. So when it came to testing the solar tracker, it did not take a rocket scientist to figure out that for the $3,400 you're gonna spend on the solar tracker, you could buy 18 of these Sirius 415 watt solar panels from Signature Solar. For the sake of argument, we decided it would be kind of more fair, and also someone that's buying a solar tracker that can only hold 400 watts of panels probably doesn't have the room for that big of an array. So we decided to compare one panel on the solar tracker to just two and see if two panels could produce more energy throughout the day than one that's following the sun. So we threw two of these panels on a static ground mount, and we threw one of them on the tracker, set them outside in the backyard where they had minimal obstructions. And as soon as the sun came up at like 7:13 a.m., we ran outside, plugged in two completely dead EcoFlow Delta Pros. They have the exact same inputs. They're both the same age, they function the same way. And we kind of just let them rip all day to see what would happen. And the test kind of went exactly how we thought it would. Initially, right away, the solar tracker was ahead. Like as soon as we plugged them into the Delta Pros, you saw the solar tracker was producing double what the static array was producing because it was actually able to spin and face the early morning sun and follow it. But that lead that the solar tracker had was over by 9 a.m. By 9 a.m., the two panels on the static stand had already caught up and were now starting to outperform. Even though they weren't at the direct angle of the sun, the two 400 watt panels were producing more than one 400 watt panel at the right angle. And that trend just continued right on throughout the day. And the more towards peak sun hours we got around 12, 1 p.m., the more the two panels were just annihilating the one panel. The solar tracker was consistent. It was getting just over 300 watts. It was kind of a hazy day. Neither set of panels were performing perfectly. Our 800 watt array, we saw a maximum of like just under 700. This one we saw a maximum of just over 300. By midday, the two panels were doing so good that it was actually 30 minutes away from filling the Delta Pro. So I went outside, I plugged the heat gun into each Delta Pro. It's a 1500 watt heat gun. I ran that load for about an hour on each of them just to drain some of the battery bank to make room to continue the testing. And then the testing kind of continued on in that same fashion. I checked every hour, but there's no need to get into the nitty gritty details of this. The point is, it carried on, and by 5:30, the tracker was back in the lead. The sun had kind of gone around the side of the panels, and the tracker was now spun facing them. And the same thing that happened in the morning, the tracker stayed consistently just under 300 following that sun, whereas the other two panels kind of fell down to about 100, 200, and they were now being outperformed. And then we got just full out clouds at like 7:30 at night, and you could see how easily the tracker just gives up when the clouds come out. So we called the test there, the tracker laid itself down, and the skies didn't look like they were gonna clear up at all. But the main point here, the results of all of the work that we did, was that we generated so much more power with two 400 watt panels throughout the course of a day than the tracker did with just one following the sun. If you needed that solar power to turn on the lights in your house, if you didn't have batteries, if you were just relying on that, the tracker is a no-brainer because it gets you fired up right in the morning and it keeps you fired up, assuming you have sunlight, all the way until the sun sets. But if you're just trying to fill a battery bank, the two panels just completely dusted in terms of how much power they generated versus the tracker. The tracker also did a few interesting things. The first one was sometimes it just loses the sun and it does full 360s and spins and can't find it, and then it figures itself back out, all of which is using energy and not producing any energy. It frequently found itself at the wrong positioning too. Sometimes we would go out and we'd be like, how's it only doing 250 watts? And we would tilt it and then it would start generating 350 watts. Like it wasn't putting itself at the right spot. I don't know what it was doing, but it was just at the wrong angle sometimes. And it also, I think it's just consuming energy. Now there's no real information on how much energy it consumes or whatever, but sometimes you go out and you could watch it go from 300 watts and it would just dip down to like 150 for 3-4 minutes and then come back to 300, which was also impacting the test results because I'm assuming it was charging its own battery so that it could follow the sun if it lost track of it, if the clouds came out and it wasn't able to steal raw power. But it did some weird stuff throughout the day and it honestly didn't even perform as well as we thought it would. It was double the solar panels, but it was over double the power in the static arrays Delta Pro than it was the tracker's Delta Pro at the end of the day. And so to put it in perspective, each solar panel, each of these Sirius solar panels is about $187 on Signature Solar's website, which is an amazing price for American made solar panels, to be honest. And so those two panels on the $100 Amazon solar panel stand that we had them mounted on, that only cost us about $472. Obviously the tracker is $3,400 plus $187 panel is about $3,587. And I think the only time a tracker makes sense is if you have a tracker on like a huge array. Something like this, you're maxing out at 400, you could easily just double it. It's harder to double a 10,000 watt array. If you're into useless inventions and gadgets and gizmos and blowing money instead of spending it wisely, Bob's your uncle, dude. Go buy one of these things. They're the coolest things ever. If you're any kind of sane though, and you have any sense of what your money can do for you, Bob's not your uncle. Bob's an idiot. Don't talk to Bob. EcoFlow, this thing was cool, but I hope if you re-release it or come up with a new one day, it is either significantly more affordable or can hold more than one solar panel. So that's it. Let me know if you guys would spend your money on this or if you think it's just as dumb as we do. Make sure you guys are subscribed if you are not already, and I'll catch you in the next one. Thank you so much for watching. Peace out and stay charged.